So who thought I was gonna end up making a fourth progress log of this? We got quite the number of changes since the last update. First, as you can see, brand new title card. As like last time, any cosmetic changes there were simply to make it just a bit more movie accurate. So the first change that was made in this new list of cosmetic changes was the skybox of No Cheese. It has now been changed to the standard Jellyfish Fields one. In the original movie game, the second combat challenge visually looked a tad like the trench level, which made sense. It had trench enemies. So, every combat arena challenge will visually look like the level it's trying to tease. In this case, it's the desert level. Not only does it use the desert skybox, but all the slammers in the level have been changed to desert slammers. Huge shoutouts to Double H for helping me on that. I changed the skybox of the first slide level to resemble that of a sunset. I didn't really have a reason to do it at the time, but the more I thought about it, the Thug Tug level's right after this, and that takes place at night. Also, the cutscene before it shows it's in the late evening, so in the end, I thought the idea worked pretty well. Also, I did not get footage of this because I didn't really want to play any of the driving levels, like, twice just to get footage. But all of the driving ring challenges have been improved. Some easy-to-miss rings have been increased in size, and every ring has a 30-second time limit. One of the changes I mentioned in the last update was I moved the placement of that god-awful final treasure chest in Bubble Blowing Baby Hunt, but I mentioned last time I couldn't really find a way to make the model show up there, and I still can't find a way to do it, but regardless, you do still collect it, just in a very bizarre way. I mentioned in the previous updates that I made a more movie-accurate sky dome for Rock Slide, so I figured I'd show it off again.
The trench is pretty deep.
And very dark.
Oh, no sweat, Mindy. We're men now. Those sea monsters wouldn't scare a guppy.
That's the spirit.
I also made one for part one of Now That We're Men. Now, I heard modifying the trench can lead to pretty broken results, so what happened as a result is all encounters of Patrick riding the tentacle, as you're about to see, are horribly broken. And the reason why the bridge is different here is because, well, the bridge would despawn upon activating. Now That We're Men Part 2 gets a complete makeover to resemble Shell City Dead Ahead. I figured I'd do this because we are literally at the part of the trench where the junkyard is just on the other side. And also, I did acknowledge the fact that the lava is now oil, as I have changed the task description of Frozen Lava Desert to say Frozen Oil Desert. Now, it should be noted, if you do not want a modified trench level, do not install the trench files that are provided in this mod. However, at the same time, I really don't recommend you do that, as that will conflict with one of the updates of this mod. So the update I literally just hinted at. I've changed the token requirements for some of your moves. The first three requirements, which are the cartwheel, the bash, and the... What do they call in the game? The slam move. I don't know what they call in the game. Those were not changed. All the later moves, on the other hand, the requirements have been changed significantly. So now, at this point in time, backtracking is no longer required in the movie game. I've lowered the requirements low enough to where you don't have to go back at all. But, as I mentioned, if you do not use the trench files I provide you, you still have to get 25 Goofy Goober tokens to get the Sponge Bowl. And, unfortunately, this also applies to Shell City Dead Ahead. So, as I was modding the game, I didn't really notice anything game-breaking in Shell City Dead Ahead till I got to 3 Meter Island. In my testings, the platforms that would spawn from hitting the buttons, they despawn immediately. I didn't know what caused it. At this time, I might have realized that might have been the token requirement. So I'm going to say, if you don't use this Shell City Dead Ahead file, there is a chance that the level will play normally, but I don't know for sure. I will say, though, if you get to Shell City Dead Ahead's challenge, the 3 Meter Island, my bad, and the cups immediately despawn, I wouldn't immediately download the file. I would actually check to see if the game crashes upon breaking the fourth TV, because if the game does not crash upon doing that, then there is just the chance that the game just did a one-time glitch. However, if either issue keeps reappearing upon, you know, reattempting the level over and over again, yeah, probably download my file. Now, what you've been seeing is my absolutely mediocre attempt to make 3 Meter Island playable. I am thinking of redoing the challenge, though, to make it where you still have to hit the buttons. Now, as for breaking the fourth TV, causing not only the game, but the emulator itself to crash, here's my rather mediocre solution. I always thought it bizarre that Planktopolis didn't feature every enemy in some way, so I fixed that problem by making Planktopolis a little more populated. Planktopolis now has their own version of the Flingers. They are just reskins of the junk Flingers, because I don't exactly know how to make brand new versions of enemies. But on top of that, I've also given Planktopolis its own set of Slammers. I have added hints to Plankton's Riddle because, just like the other challenge Planktopolis has that involves points, people absolutely suck at this part. I've mentioned this in my last update too, but I went ahead and made getting the last two sets of goodies in Planktopolis way easier to collect, because now you don't have to climb the wall twice. Instead, you can use these platforms I provided you. And on top of that, I've also added platforms that will allow you to go back to the top of the wall jump area. So again, you don't have to use the wall jump multiple times. I only did this because I always found that to be very time-consuming. Another update to the second part of Planktopolis. We all know the Merv section, so I changed it. Now, as you'll see over in the final platform, I've added more Krabby Patties, so that way, no matter what, when you get to the final Plankton statue, you will have enough health. And that's just about all I have to show you. I have more planned features for this mod in the future, but as of now, I don't really know how to implement them. Now, it's come to my attention as of recently, sound replacement in the game is now possible to an extent, but I still need to learn a little how to do that before I consider replacing any sound in the game. And as of very recently, there is now a tool to add custom FMVs to Movie Game, but I'm gonna be honest, I've tried it. I must be doing something wrong, because it still doesn't work for me. If I figure out what I'm doing wrong, though, you bet your ass that the next update is gonna include brand new cutscenes. So until then, this is the Koopy Illuminator, signing out.